I'm going to explain the size dependent band gap of semiconductor quantum dots. As you have learned from our previous classes that the band gap of a quantum dot increases with the decrease in the particle size. So Brass was the first to make a theoretical calculations connecting the particle size or radius of the quantum dots with the band gap. And he used an effective mass approximation for this purpose and considered both the quantum confinement effect and Coulomb charge screening. So, as we know, a semiconductor has a band gap, and in bulk state is represented by Eg bulk, and in nanoscale, when it is in the form of quantum dot, it is Eg of quantum dot. So it has two additional contributions in the nanoscale. The first one is the quantum confinement effect due to the confinement of carriers, confinement of excitons within the small potential of the nanocrystal, which gives rise to this term. And here you can see that it varies inversely proportional to R square. And the last term here contributing to the band gap of quantum dot is the Coulomb screening interaction, or simply the Coulombic interaction, which is inversely proportional to R and which has basically a negative contribution, which tends to reduce the band gap. So in semiconductor quantum dots, there is a competition between this quantum confinement effect and Coulombic interaction. And this term dominates when the particle size is very small. Later, considering the electron hole pair spatial correlation effect, Kayanuma modified Brass equation with an additional term, given as this one. It is basically known as the salvation energy, and in most of the cases, it is very small. And you can also see that this term is independent of the radius of the quantum dots. So if we look at the experimental data, here we have represented two size dependent band gap. One is for cadmium selenium, and this is for cadmium telluride. Here you see if the particle size is reduced from 6 nanometer to 1 nanometer, you can see the band gap reduced from enhances from 1.8 to about 2.75 in case of cadmium selenium, whereas similar types of observation was also reported in case of cadmium telluride. And this dots basically represents the experimental points, and this straight line represents the actual theoretically fitted data.